All right, I am here. I'm queer, and you might be too, or you're an ally. Either way, we are here for a very specific reason, and that reason is to go over another React LGBTQ series scene. So the scene that we're going to react to today is In Love, Simon. You probably already know what this is from the thumbnail, and if you haven't, boy, do I have a treat for you, and that treat is going to come in the form of cold chills and possibly a crying. So you are very welcome. I am glad that I could help bestow that upon you. I've seen this scene many, many a times, and I still get in my feels when I watch it. So let's go ahead and just start watching the scene. If I need to stop in just a minute in order to do something, then we will.
Did you know?
Oh.
I knew you had a secret.
Okay. I'm actually going to pause just for a second. Because number one, the tension just in that specific scene, I think a lot of people in the LGBTQ community felt, because that is like the heavy tension that you mainly get in any type of awkward situation, but when it's focused around a secret that you've had your entire life, it is just, it's different. It is way worse. But I'm also going to tell you, your mom knows. She knew, but she didn't say anything. And you'll see in this case in just a second.
When you were little, you were so carefree. But these last few years, more and more, it's almost like I could feel you holding your breath.
Oh. Same queen.
I wanted to ask you about it, but I didn't want to pry.
Because you're a good mom?
Oh. Maybe I made a mistake.
No. No, Mom. You didn't make a mistake.
Being gay is your thing.
Okay, I'm going to pause one more time right here. I just feel like I need to because this is such a famous scene. I feel like just watching it from start to finish and then saying something about it at the very end is not going to do it justice. Because she's about to go into a little bit of a monologue here, talking to Simon, which is the part that I think everyone gets the goosies, goosebumps. They're goosebumps. And the emotionalness of the whole scene just kind of hits you like a ton of bricks. The sincerity and like the soft soothing, and it's like a very type of like buttery smooth. I actually had to learn it whenever I started doing my ASMR channel, not plugging. I just, you know, I have one, and it's very, you kind of have to calm down your voice. You have to kind of provide a certain amount of comfort just from the tone of your voice like this. So that way, whenever you speaking to someone, they're a little bit more at ease because you're not just throwing stuff at them like this lazily with your diaphragm. You're bringing it down and you're kind of just talking to someone the way that you would normally talk to your kids and a little kid if you don't want to scare them. But you kind of get the gist of it with the tone of my voice whenever I'm talking to you like this. And this is kind of what she does. So she like brings you down into comfort mode and then she just makes you cry like that. So
there are parts of it you have to go through alone. I hate that. As soon as you came out, you said, "Mom, I'm still me."
Here it comes.
I need you to hear this. You are still you, Simon. You are still the same son who I love to tease, and who your father depends on for just about everything. And you're the same brother who always compliments his sister on her food, even when it sucks. You get to exhale now, Simon. Mm-hmm. You get to be more you than you have been in a very long time. You deserve everything you want.
She is everyone's mother. She's everyone's mom. And it, like, she immediately became somebody who provided the comfort that her son needed. And if you are a very close ally or you are a member of the queer community, then 9 times out of 10, this was a type of comfort that you needed that you did not get. And when you see someone else getting it, or you see it in movies or cinema, or you see certain type of comfort that is being provided that you did not have, it does 2 things at the same time. It makes you feel happy that someone else is getting that and that you're able to witness that happen. And then it also makes you just really kind of in your feels and sad because you are watching someone else get something that you very desperately wanted and never got. If you want to drop a comment down below and let me know if there is a specific scene in a movie or if there is a specific TV show or any type of media that you really want to watch or you really want my opinion or take or reaction video or anything, please drop a comment down below. I have an extremely long list, but if you guys request something more than once or really want to see it, then I will bump it up and we will make a video out of it. So again, I'm tired. I'm ending this video. I have a lot more shit to film. And I'm really excited to get it out to you guys, so I will see you hopefully in the comments.